Hi, my name is Julie Calza, and I'm here to bring you the Ask Julie C Real Estate Show. In today's episode, we're going to go over closing costs and how they impact you as a borrower and how they could affect you as a seller. Let's talk about closing costs. Closing costs are a really scary concept, especially if you're new to the process of buying or selling. The most important thing to realize is in using a VA loan, you don't have to come to the table with a down payment, but you do still incur closing costs. And as a seller, no matter what your original loan type was, you will have closing costs as well. More times than not, sellers' closing costs are a little bit higher than what buyers' closing costs are. So make sure that you're adequately prepared for closing costs. As a buyer using your VA loan, you may not realize that these closing costs are a very substantial factor in the home purchase process. These closing costs comprise of loan origination fees, title fees, impounds, prepaids, your insurance, your interest, and all sorts of other things that all comprise into these different amounts that are itemized to you throughout the process. It just starts looking really intimidating and confusing. Title fees are the fees associated with transferring the title of the property into your name, aka the deed. The title company will also go through different things during the process to ensure the property can transfer and that the seller has a clear title. Think Carfax for a home. That's really what the title company's job is to get that report and make sure that the title is all in good, clean bill of health in order for you to purchase the home without any negative surprises. The title company will also provide you insurance on this service, so that way if anything is found after the fact, then you do have backup and can get that resolved easily. Loan costs are only applicable if you're on the buyer side of the transaction. Loan costs are things like loan origination fees, flood certification, documents fees, and the list goes on and on. This is one way that lender choice comes into factor. A lot of people like to just rate shop on a loan, but in reality, you need to look at different facets for each lender that you evaluate, because different costs are going to be associated with different lenders and different amounts for each line item. Again, this can wrap you down a crazy rabbit hole if we go super in depth, so make sure that you just go back and ask your agent to prepare you for these loan costs and other closing costs. When you buy a home, you have to prepay certain items. It is normal with a VA loan for you to have a processing period in between payments. So you have to prepay things like HOA, interest, insurance, and taxes all the way up until your first payment is due. These become part of closing costs. Closing costs, prepaids, and impounds, those two terms are used interchangeably. Impound is actually the act of that amount being held back for you and paid on your behalf. So don't let those two terms confuse you in the process. Realtor fees are 100% between you and your representation. Make sure you have a clear-cut agreement with your real estate professional so you know what to anticipate in the process in regards to realtor fees that become closing costs. I see too many times buyers and sellers using different representation get to the finish line and not actually know what they're paying or what to expect. So ensure you're asking the right questions when you first meet with your representation and make sure you have a clear-cut picture of what to anticipate from them in the closing process. All in all, when you're buying a home, a really good rule of thumb for closing costs is 3% of the purchase price. That's what almost any lender and real estate agent will tell you to anticipate. So that can be a really large amount. I mean, think of a $200,000 purchase price, that's $6,000. Know that these closing costs are 100% negotiable. And a lot of times your agent can negotiate for the seller to pay these closing costs on your behalf at close of escrow so you can come out of pocket as little as possible to buy a home. On the other hand, as a seller, make sure that your agent is having that conversation with you to set you up for the expectations in the market. You should be asking your representation questions like, what's normal in the market for a seller to cover? That way you can make sure that you're adequately prepared at the end. This is another example of why who you work with really matters in this process, because your representation really sets the stage for how closing costs are gonna go and how prepared you are for closing costs at the end of the process and throughout. The most important thing you can do to control your costs is to set clear expectations with your representation, make sure you're asking the important questions, and as a seller, ensure that you're getting net sheets from your representation to tell you what you can expect from the proceeds of your sale at the end of the process. And as a buyer, make sure you're getting the same kind of calculations so you know what you can anticipate either coming to the table with at the end of the process, or know without a shadow of a doubt if you will have to come to the table with any funds or not. In short, if you've just begun the process of weighing out if homeownership is right for you or if now is the time to sell, don't let closing costs scare you away. There's nearly always a creative solution for closing costs and other things that are gonna come up during the process. While you should be prepared in the way of knowing that closing costs exist, don't let them stand in your way of investing in real estate or cashing out the investment you already have. Thank you for tuning into the Ask Julie C. Real Estate Show. Do you have questions about closing costs, or are you still really intimidated about the concept of them? I'm sure you are. It's a rabbit hole. I could talk on it for days. Go to juliecalza.com to binge watch all the episodes of Ask Julie C, or to read more articles on closing costs, or to fill out a contact request form and I'll answer your questions directly. You'll also find my contact information at the end of this episode. Thank you again for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.